Hello and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on writing equilibrium constant expressions. So remember that chemical equilibrium is reached when the rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse chemical reaction. And so we designate our reactions here with these double-sided arrows, indicating that this would be the forward direction as we go from reactants to products, and this would be the reverse reaction as we go from products to reactants. And so chemical equilibrium is reached when these rates are equal. And so when considering a chemical reaction at equilibrium, we can write an equilibrium expression. This is derived from the law of mass action that expresses the relationship between the concentration of the reactants and the concentrations of the products that are present at equilibrium. And so we are going to call our equilibrium constant K, and K is going to be equal to the concentration of each product raised to the respective coefficient from our balanced chemical equation. So the concentration of C raised to the coefficient in front of C in our balanced chemical equation times the concentration of D raised to the coefficient of D in our chemical equation divided by the concentrations of our reactants raised to the power of their respective coefficients. And so this value for your equilibrium constant K allows us to express the relationship between the concentrations of these reactants and products at equilibrium. There are a few different ways you can write equilibrium constants. In general, we call the equilibrium constant here K, but you can also be more specific and label this K sub C. And in this case, the concentrations of your reactants and your products would have units of molarity. So this is moles per liter. But also, if you have a reaction where all of your reactants and products are gases, you can also write an equilibrium constant expression and specify the value of your equilibrium constant to be K sub P, where instead of concentrations and molarity, we're looking at the concentrations essentially of our reactants and products in terms of partial pressures. And understanding gas laws would allow you to be able to convert between concentrations and partial pressures, but you can do this one of two ways. Other things that we want to keep in mind about our equilibrium constants is that these are specific for a particular reaction at a defined temperature, and also that we don't worry about units for these values, either K sub P or K sub C. So let's go ahead and practice here writing some equilibrium expressions, and we're going to write these in terms of K sub C. So we would use concentrations and molarity here. So let's go ahead and write some of these equilibrium expressions, and let's start with number one here. So KC is going to be equal to the concentration of our products. In this case, we only have one product, ammonia, NH3, raised to the power of the coefficient from our balanced chemical equation. And this is going to be divided by the concentration of our reactants, in this case, N2, raised to the power of 1, and H2 raised to the power of 3. And so again, where this value here, K sub C, is a constant, this is going to describe to us the relationship of the concentrations of ammonia, nitrogen, and hydrogen when this reaction is at equilibrium. Okay, let's look at another example here. So this chemical reaction is the conversion of ozone to molecular oxygen. And so our value for K sub C is going to be equal to the concentration of our products, O2, raised to the power of the coefficient, so O2 cubed, divided by the concentration of our reactant, O3, raised to the power of the coefficient from the balanced chemical equation, so O3 squared. And one last one for good measure here. K sub C for this equation is going to be equal to the concentration of our product, HI squared, divided by the concentration of our reactants. So H2 times I2, because the coefficients in front of H2 and I2 are 1. This video is specifically on writing equilibrium expressions, but check out the next video for working with and interpreting equilibrium constants for a little more insight into the information that we can gain from these equilibrium constants and from these expressions. Okay, so we know that the value of our equilibrium constant is specific for a given reaction at a given temperature, but also from looking at these expressions, we can tell that the value of the equilibrium constant depends only on the stoichiometry of the reaction and not the reaction mechanism. One last thing, if you're given just K or a value of KEQ, you can assume this is referring to K sub C and that your units of your reactants and your products are in molarity, which again is moles per liter. One last thing I wanted to cover in this tutorial is when we have homogeneous versus heterogeneous equilibria. So for homogeneous equilibria, we have all reactants and products in the same phase. And so all of the examples that we looked at here had all of our reactants and products in the same phase. These were all gases. But you can also have scenarios where you have heterogeneous equilibria, where not all of your reactants and products would be in the same phase. And this can have some implications for writing our equilibrium expressions. And one of the things that we want to remember with this is that the concentrations of pure solids and pure liquids are not included in equilibrium constant expressions, even though they must still be present for equilibrium to occur. And I'm not going to get into the reasons for this, but one way that you can think about this is that if you have a pure solid in your chemical reaction, and you were to increase the amount of your pure solid in this chemical reaction, you would increase the mass of the solid, but the volume of that solid would also increase. And so the ratio there, the concentration of your solid, is staying the same. And so this is one way to think about why these concentrations of pure solids and pure liquids are not included. You can also look into this more with respect to activity, but that's not something we're going to talk about in this tutorial. So in our equilibrium constant expressions, we are going to include the concentrations of gases and also of solutes dissolved in solution, so designated by this AQ symbol here, but not the concentrations of pure solids and pure liquids. And so let's look at how we would write our equilibrium expression for some of these scenarios here. And so the value of Kc for this first example here would be equal to the concentration of our products. So in this case, lead 2 plus ions raised to the power of the coefficient from our balanced chemical equation, which is just 1, multiplied by the concentration of our chloride ions raised to the power of the respective coefficient, so squared. And we would normally divide by the concentration of our reactants, but notice that in this scenario here, we're looking at the process of lead chloride dissolving. We have lead chloride the solid, and so that is not included in our equilibrium expression. Even though we know that you would have to have some lead chloride solid present for this equilibrium to be established. And so here, our value for our equilibrium expression is just going to be equal to the concentration of lead times the concentration of chloride ions squared. And this is something that will be revisited looking at specifically solubility equilibria in another tutorial. Okay, one last example. Our equilibrium constant is going to be equal to the concentration of our products, so carbon monoxide, raised to the power of the respective coefficient, which is 1. But then our other product is H2O, which is a pure liquid here, designated by this L symbol. And so we omit that from our equilibrium expression. And so we would divide the concentration of carbon monoxide by the concentration of our reactants, CO2, raised to the first power, multiplied by the concentration of H2. And so that is going to wrap up this tutorial, but check back for more videos on interpreting and working with equilibrium constants, and also for more calculations involving equilibrium constants.